Like to welcome everyone to this joint meeting of the P20 Council with Arches, where we have a chance as this nascent VC STEM network to be able to talk to you about what we've done over the last year. And so to get us started here, I'd like to introduce President Richard Rush. President Rush hired me back in 2001 away from the University of New Mexico. It was the best decision I ever made in my life. It's been an amazing journey. An amazing president. I'm only sad that he'll be retiring at the end of this year. But Richard, can you come on up and start us off here?
Thank you, Phil. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. We're delighted that you're here for this exciting event, and we have a perfect day for it, so we're being blessed all around. This afternoon, we are celebrating the launch of the Ventura County STEM Regional Collaborative, which is an initiative of the P20 Council and currently facilitated by Cal State Channel Islands. We would not be able to do this did we not have generous funding from the Amgen Foundation, and we're very, very grateful for that. The Ventura County P20 Council is now about 12 years old. I really do need to go back and find out exactly when we started it. But it is a collaboration of all the segments of education in Ventura County, as well as the business and nonprofit communities. Its sole purpose is to support our school districts so that our children will have an unsullied continuum from the time that they're munchkins all the way through graduate school. The purpose of this is to provide them with an opportunity for a better life, to contribute to the 21st century as it develops, but it's also intended to support the workforce needs of our region. Without that kind of focus and attention, we don't believe that we'll be able to be successful to the degree that we have in the past. So let me introduce the members of the P20 Council who are here with us today. First of all, Chancellor Bernie Luskin of the Ventura County Community College District. Captain Chris Jockey, who is in the back. I haven't seen Eric Harrison from United Way, the President of United Way. He's going to be here. Claudia Harrison, who is the Executive Director of First Five of Ventura County. Maria Steck, the Vice President of 12th District PTA. I haven't seen Maria, and Richard Duarte, the project coordinator for the P20 Council. I know there's Richard back there. So I'm delighted that this number of my colleagues have been able to join us this afternoon. VC STEM is a strong example of the synergy and collective vision of educators, industry, and organizations throughout our county, all working together to promote excellence in P20 in our schools, to promote excellence in STEM education, and to prepare our students, as I said, for the needs and the demands of the 21st century. It might be interesting to note that the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics related jobs survey projected us to grow to more than 9 million jobs between 2012 and 2022. That's a 12% increase. So the need for these kinds of opportunities is apparent to all of us. VC STEM is intended to prepare our students all the way from pre-K into career for this reality, this number of jobs which will be available, by promoting interest in and access to STEM educational programs, reaching children at their earliest years. I don't know about you, I'm blessed. I have 7 grandkids now. But I remember my own kids and the grandkids. They are natural scientists. Have you ever seen a 2-year-old in the backyard with a sourdough rolling one of those little things up? And he's filled with wonder. How does this work? And somewhere along the line, this natural scientist in them seems to go at least dormant, at most away. And we need to capture that from the time that they're small. And now, an unpaid commercial. Tomorrow night, we're having our science carnival in Oxnard. The ubiquitous Phil Hampton has created yet another fantastic program, and the things that he does to encourage children at their earliest ages all the way through to find science not only interesting but fascinating is remarkable. So if you have time, please attend. I won't be able to this year, I'll be out of town, but I've been at every other one, and it's just amazing. And you see the children's eyes open up like this. We have to keep those eyes open all the way through their educational process. So once we've captured them, we need to develop clear education pathways so that we can build on the wonder and keep creating these scientists. We want to support our STEM programs across the board. CI is opening its engineering program in fall of 16 as one of the other elements that we're trying to contribute to this. And the VC STEM is providing professional development opportunities for educators as well, for educators to be at and continue to be at the cutting edge. I'm proud to say, if you haven't already become aware, that VC STEM was named a STEM ecosystem by the STEM Funders Network, which makes this region only one of 27 in the country so designated. And it's devoted to creating STEM learning opportunities for the students pre-K all the way through college. At this time, I want to go back and recognize the Amgen Foundation. All of us know that we can have great ideas, but if we don't have the support to implement them, we run the risk of not being able to do so. Today, the Amgen Foundation is represented by Dr. Cindy Alshari, who is the Vice President of the Department of Comparative Biology and Safety Sciences and Chair of the Amgen Foundation Grant Review Committee. I want to thank Cindy and the Amgen Foundation for their generous contribution of $75,000 for the planning of VC STEM and for the investment in our children and in our county's future through their support of the formation, launch, and implementation of VC STEM. I also want to thank you for the continued support for the additional $100,000 to implement VC STEM. We'll have a check presentation later, and I hope it'll be in small bills, and I'll tuck it right here in my pocket. So let me at this time welcome and have the honor of welcoming Dr. Alshari to say a few words. Cindy.
It's a real pleasure to be here, certainly as a working mother and citizen of Ventura County. I've had two boys who've benefited from, they're not quite to the graduate school stage, but from that young age through the high school and early college years here, have benefited from some of the work and the outreach that's been done by this group. Ventura County is home to Amgen's global headquarters, and as a science-based company, we're heavily investing in inspiring the innovators of tomorrow, particularly those in our own backyard. Looking beyond our company and even the biotechnology sector, we need an educated workforce to ensure that scientific innovation persists. Innovation doesn't happen in a vacuum. It requires creativity, content expertise, and risk-taking, and thoughtful thinking outside the box. After a year of strategic outreach and deliberate planning, VC STEM is well positioned to dig into the important work of strengthening STEM education for Ventura County students. As a founding founder of VC STEM, the Amgen Foundation is proud of the work that this collaborative has accomplished to date and is excited for its future. We'd like to congratulate you on achieving that recognition as an ecosystem. The Amgen Foundation is committed to raising the value of science literacy through strengthening science teacher quality and professional development and offering pivotal hands-on science experiences and significantly impacting students' excitement about science and scientific careers. We recognize that addressing global STEM gap requires participation between industry, academia, and the nonprofit organizations to create the greater capacity for innovation. And that is precisely what VC STEM is positioned to do in our community. We're very enthusiastic about the multi-sector partnership that is being developed by VC STEM and look forward to actively participating in the evolution of the VC STEM learning ecosystem. On behalf of the Amgen Foundation, it is my pleasure to recognize the hard work of the team here with the $100,000 grant to continue to support this innovative model and ensure future innovation. Thank you for your commitment and hard work towards STEM education.
Thank you, Cindy, and thank you for taking time to join us today. It's a pleasure to have you with us. At this time, I want to recognize some of the collaborators in the room who have joined us. Some, I think, are still facing traffic. We're expecting quite a few others, and it's a Friday afternoon, so they may be facing some of the challenges of the roadway. But one of the things that I would point out is that this entire effort is being implemented by an awful lot of people of talent and commitment in this region because they believe in the future and they want to contribute to creating it. So the first collaborator I would like to introduce are the VC STEM consultants who have been instrumental in lending their expertise and experience in the planning efforts. Would you please stand and be recognized? We're happy today that Beth Yeager was able to join us. Stephanie Couch it was also instrumental in this effort, but she's not able to be with us today, but we'll extend our appreciation to Stephanie as well. The VC STEM Steering Committee members who are with us, would you please stand and be recognized? Finally, the VC STEM Initiative co-chairs. The co-chairs, please stand and receive raucous applause. Thank you all, and thank you for your continued participation in this absolutely essential effort. And now I'm honored to introduce Tiffany Morris, who's the Director of Career Education and the Director of the Ventura County Innovates Program, to speak on behalf of the Ventura County Office of Education.
Thank you. I'm pleased to be here today on behalf of Superintendent Mantu, who is out of town, but really wanted to send his congratulations to the team. I was thinking as I was coming here about what we're here to celebrate today, and I was thinking about the word ecosystem. We are one of these 27 ecosystems. And I was thinking, what does it mean to be an ecosystem? And an ecosystem is a place where organisms and their environment work together as a system. And I think it's no accident that the word ecosystem was chosen to select what we're doing here. Our work is firmly grounded within our local community, within our environment, and what's happening right here in Ventura County with our amazing business partners, we're sitting here, this great geological feature that we have access to. So we are firmly rooted in our community, and then we have all of these great organizations that come together to work together as a system. And I think that's really important. And I think in the last few years, we've made a lot of progress towards doing this, not the least of which is this group that's here today. In the last 8 years, Ventura County has had $74 million in state and federal funds dedicated to improving STEM education in the county. That's really amazing. But our challenge is to make sure that we're doing that in a thoughtful and connected way as an ecosystem, as organizations working together with our environment. The Ventura County Office of Education is proud to be one part of that ecosystem among many of the others that are sitting here today. And we are very grateful for the work of our partners throughout the community and the continuance and the ability to do good things for students in our county.
Thank you, Tiffany. And now I am delighted to introduce the mover and the shaker. But let me have one moment of personal privilege. Phil Hampton said that was the best thing that's ever happened to him, that he accepted my invitation to join me here and create this university. Phil has done an amazing job, not only for students, but for the community, but also the discipline of chemistry as well. He has truly been a creator in this university, and it has been, Phil, my honor to have you as a colleague. Dr. Phil Hampton.
Make me emotional here. Let's start. Wow, this has been a whirlwind. You know, we started this adventure back in 2011 when Marcella Klein Williams, who was working with the California STEM Learning Network, came to us and said, how about a STEM regional network in Ventura County? And look where we are today. Let's give ourselves a hand for where we've come to. How am I supposed to advance slides? Is that the laptop down here? Okay. Yeah. I thought at least I'd get a clicker. There we go. Okay, so VC STEM is stewarded by the Ventura County P20 Council and facilitated by CSU Channel Islands. And we're very grateful to Amgen Foundation for providing us with the $75,000 initial funding for this planning year leading to the launch today of the VC STEM Network. So as you know, the P20 Council is a cross-sector group of key decision makers from education, business, parent organizations, and community agencies. And they're addressing education from preschool all the way through graduate school. And eliminating gaps in our educational process, advancing college preparation and completion for all students in Ventura County. And I think it's no surprise that this is a really great way to launch VC STEM as a partnership and under the P20 Council with its amazing plan of trying to enhance education in our region. So a little bit of a story behind VC STEM. So this is our new logo. If you ever want a logo, Fiverr, you can get it for $30. Whole annual report, $120. 24 hours. Okay, I've sold enough here. So the leaders of Ventura County, VC STEM, reflects the roots of this diverse agricultural community. They can be described as essential, salt of the earth, modest, and unendingly hardworking. And this crew is hardworking. This last week, with working with Melissa and Megan, it's been a really hardworking week, and Marcella has just stepped up to deliver amazing content and programming to make this day a success. We're excited about bringing together our community of culture of collaboration and innovation and to try to intentionally learn fast by learning together. So according to the 2015 Harvard University Childhood Exposure Effects and County Level Estimates study, Ventura County is one of the better counties in the U.S. for helping poor children climb up the income ladder, ranking better than 70% of all counties nationwide for the future upward mobility of our youth. As was pointed out several times, we've had over $74 million in funding flow into Ventura County from either the state of California or from the U.S. Department of Education. And this is in the form of Hispanic-serving institution grants, Magnet School Assistance Program grants, and the Career Pathways Trust grants that we've been so successful at securing in our region. So overall, Ventura County represents a county with outstanding but independent efforts related to STEM education, and it's our challenge as we move forward to continue to build a true ecosystem in our region by working together. So this started like any other entity. A group of people saw promise, and they committed to try to take what was an idea to a completion. And we're thankful to Amgen for helping us achieve this goal today. So I'd like to introduce our current steering committee. They stood earlier, but I would like to have them stand when I announce their names. We have Julia Chambers, Richard Duarte, Grady Hammerhand, Claudia Harrison, Cynthia Herrera, who couldn't be with us today with Oxnard College, Nathan Inouye, Monica James, who could not be with us here today, Dr. Marcella Klein-Williams, Dr. Tiffany Morris, Jim Rose, and Maria Steck. So we have a token of our appreciation here that Marcella is handing around. President Rush has one of these name tags. He's a catalyst. Somehow I'm a conductor. I don't know what I'm conducting, but I know I do conduct electricity after that experiment this morning in the lab. You don't want to know about that one, do you? So thank you. Give our steering committee a hand, please. So BC STEM is anchored by this passionate and dedicated group of strong individuals who are committed to the enlightened interest of all of our partners and to share a collective vision regarding excellence in P20 education. These steering committee members represent a broad set of sectors in Ventura County, from the P20 Council membership to K-12 education, PK-12 education, Workforce Investment Board, now known as the Workforce Development Board, the military, nonprofits, and business. And Ventura County is a rich county from the standpoint of STEM. We have a beautiful natural landscape with the Channel Islands National Park, the Santa Monica Mountains Recreation Area, the Los Padres National Forest, 43 miles of shoreline, and harbor and rich agricultural land. And we are ripe for an outstanding growth in STEM education in our region. So this unique and natural cultural history of Ventura County and its numerous STEM companies, including Amgen at the lead, make Ventura County a natural fit to become a hub for innovation in STEM teaching and learning. So this is our timeline that we started on. We're on task here. We said that we would start with planning stage of looking at, form a steering committee, develop a draft mission and vision and some approaches, to then spend the early summer identifying some co-chairs to lead action groups. I'm going to announce them in just a little bit. To hold some convenings, to talk about what we would like to achieve in each of our action group areas. And then from July to September, to continue to evolve strategic initiatives, develop strategic plans, also we're calling them strategic frameworks, and then to pursue a second Amgen proposal, and didn't realize we'd actually have that for today, but a successful second Amgen Foundation proposal. And now we are here at the end of October launching the VC STEM Network and poised to move into a second year of the launch of VC STEM. We have three preliminary strategies that we've pursued, and then a fourth one that was existing under current grants within the region. The first is at the PK through grade 3 level, and that is the Early STEM Learning Action Group. Second, an expanded learning opportunities in STEM group that looks at informal education, after-school programming, and summer education, including museums and nonprofit work with kids. A professional learning opportunities in STEM for educators, taking a look at the implementation of the next generation science standards and how can we support our teachers. And then the very successful career pathways area, which we're going to continue to evolve in this upcoming year and find ways of collaborating with and expanding our linkage to them. In the future, you may see come out of us a retention and graduation initiative efforts as well. So I'd like to now, do you want to do name tags now or later on? Okay, later on. So you, co-chairs, you're going to get name tags too. Don't worry, we'll be giving them to you a little bit. We already got them, okay. All right, so I'd like to introduce our first group of co-chairs, and if you'll stand when your name's announced. We have Claudia Harrison, who's the Executive Director of First Five Ventura County. Dr. Carola Matera, Assistant Professor of the Early Childhood Education at Cal State Chalons, and Carola couldn't be with us today. Carrie Murphy, Director of Early Childhood Programs with the Ventura County Office of Education, and Dr. Elizabeth Quintero, Professor of Education, Early Childhood Education Programs at Cal State Chalons, and she could not be with us today. Thank you. A second action group that we have is the Expanded Learning Action Group. And leading this as co-chairs include Sandy Birmingham, Associate Director of STEM Educational Outreach at Cal State Channel Islands, Julia Chambers, who's Board President of Gullwings Children Museum, and the Executive Director of Channel Islands Maritime Museum, this beautiful facility that we've had an opportunity to meet in today. And don't miss the tour right after this. And then finally, Ginger Shea, who's Manager of Special Programs at the Oxnard School District, and Ginger could not be with us today. Thank you. And then our final action group that we pursued during this planning year was STEM Professional Learning. And the co-chairs of this group included Dr. Colleen Robertson, the superintendent of the Somas Union School District, Dr. Grady Hanrahan, professor and associate provost for experiential learning. Your title's longer than that one, isn't it? Yeah, it's a title that I envy. Where did Dick go? I told him I want that title or something like that. Yeah, okay. And the final, I serve on this committee as well as Professor of Chemistry and Director of our HSI STEM grant. Thank you. And then our final action area is the College and Career Pathways area, led by Dr. Tiffany Morris, Director of Career Education with Ventura County Office of Education, Jim Rose, Director of Career Pathways and Community Partnerships, Oxnard Union High School District. Let's give our co-chairs a This is exciting. This is truly exciting. Back in June, late May, early June, Scott Heimlich said he'd like to share an idea with us, an opportunity that we might consider. And he proposed it. Scott is VP of the Amgen Foundation. And he said, you know, if we nominated you, would you consider applying? And, you know, how do you say anything but yes to that? This unique opportunity to be considered as a STEM ecosystem. And they were only going to identify 25 of them. We were told that 15 of them had already been identified. So there were really only 10 left that you could compete for. So we wrote a very strong proposal, a writing team consisting of Marcella Klein-Williams, myself, and we had help from a large number of other people who edited, read content, and gave us ideas, wrote an outstanding proposal to the STEM Funders Network. And as a result of that proposal, we were recognized now as one of 27 communities selected as STEM ecosystems. And we are headed to Washington the second week of November, a team of four of us, Jessica Halloran from the Amgen Foundation, Tiffany Morris from VCOE, Marcella, and myself, road trip to Washington, and we're going to even be in the White House during that visit. So let's give ourselves a hand for this outstanding. And we're here today. We used to show this slide earlier in the year of something in the future, and it's now. We are launching today, here today, and at 4:30, we will have the recognition of EC STEM as a network. Please consider coming tomorrow night. My back is hurting right now from loading pallets in the warehouse. It's a labor of love for me to bring the Science Carnival every year to the community. It's something that is a partnership, a true partnership. We have First Five Ventura County volunteering along with Child Development Resources. We've got Wainimi High School, we've got Pacifica, we have numerous partners in this event, and it's characteristic of our ecosystem nature here in Ventura County. Oh, and Gullwings is going to have a wonderful booth on my Dark Knight sauna location activity. So if you want to act like a blind bat, show up and go try that activity. All right, today we used to call this our sacrificial draft of what our vision and mission are for our network. This is now our final version. We are now a vision of what P20 education might be in Ventura County. So our vision is shown here. I'll give you just a few seconds to read it over yourselves. I particularly like the last line, how we're impacting the region and the world. It's not just about making money in Ventura County. It's changing the world, changing. We've got a lot of challenges that will be facing us in this generation with regard to the environment. And we need strong, STEM-educated students who will be our future leaders and how we can respond to it. We also now have our official mission, which is that Ventura County STEM Network serves as a leadership hub for regional stakeholders who are working together to improve educational outcomes in STEM throughout Ventura County. So this is now no longer a sacrificial draft, it's solid. We also have a number of goals that are now being pursued as a result of the launch of VC STEM. One of those goals is to increase STEM interest and to especially look at gaps. Where in our county are kids getting STEM in the schools, and where are they not? And how can we address the issue where STEM education and the quality of STEM education to some extent is affected by your zip code? We're also going to be taking a look at, from the standpoint of a goal, not just staying with STEM. I mean, STEM is science, technology, engineering, and math, but there are lots of vehicles and extensions of STEM. They include agriculture, also the arts. And you get to be a really long acronym when you include in recreation and then your stream. It's come a long way since I was in graduate school when they called STEM SMET. Why they ever called it SMET, I have no idea. It wasn't the thing to pursue, science, math, engineering, and technology. So calling it STEM has been a big blessing, I think, for the sciences. Here's some more of our goals here. Ensure that California students are college and career ready. And to build a network that connects together our employers, educators, and policymakers so that we can have strong education in our schools. And Ventura County, a STEM regional network, will do this by coordinating and activating a multi-sector network of STEM leaders, policymakers, business and industry stakeholders, governmental agencies to integrate STEM programming efforts throughout the county to try to build a true ecosystem in our region. So I'm going to move on now to let the action group say a little bit about what they've been up to. This planning year was creating ideas. This next year, with the next Amgen grant, the $100,000 Amgen grant, we're taking these ideas to action. And so the action groups will receive, as part of that grant funding, to start doing things, start planning things. And some of the things that these action groups are likely to be doing and will be doing, first of all, we will continue to convene, bringing together the members of the action group together along with their stakeholders. Second thing we're going to be doing is looking for practices worthy of attention. So that's a phrase that we've picked up as the STEM network, practices worthy of attention. We're not calling them best practices. We're saying these are things that work in our region. Hey, you might want to pay attention to them and you may want to adopt them. So we're going to be looking for those in our county and documenting them. And then taking that documentation and sharing it through a variety of means, including our website, which has been launched, as well as an annual celebration of STEM excellence that we will start holding in our region. Okay, at this point, I would like to move on and have the action groups each have the opportunity to talk about what they've been up to. And so I'd like to call Jim and Tiffany up to talk about the College and Career Pathway Action Group area.
So we throw the word pathways around quite a bit, and it doesn't really have a very good definition. But in this county, what we're working towards is building a sequence of activities for students, beginning as early as possible, PK and beyond, all the way up to our post-secondary training. And I want to tell you a story about what this could look like. So we had a tour out to Naval Base Ventura County, and I have an administrator in our system that doesn't really understand STEM. I know he doesn't really get pathways, he doesn't really get STEM. So I said, you know what, I need you to be a chaperone on this trip out to the base. So he went as a chaperone, and he came back and he said, Tiffany, if you asked me what engineers did this morning, I would have said something with railroads. I don't know what they do. But it's amazing. There are really great, cool things happening out there on the base behind the gates that he would never see. And he said, I told my daughter she should be an engineer. So he went home and said, it's so great. She said, Dad, that's really boring. She goes to one of our magnet schools. Being a good parent, he signed her up for the STEM camp anyways. And so she went to the STEM camp over the summer at the base and came back and said, Dad, I think I want to be an engineer. And guess what? We have this system, this pathway system now, where she's going to have a place right here in Ventura County to go and study engineering. She's just starting as an eighth grader, but she can go through high school programs as an intro engineering. She can learn, explore, figure out what kind of engineering she's interested in, all the way to the post-secondary opportunities, and hopefully right back to a job here in our community. That's what we're doing with Pathways. And we're really excited because it takes an entire system to make those opportunities available for students. It's not just the educational components, but it's exposing them to what's available right here in our community so that they can imagine and envision the possibilities for their own future, be motivated and excited and linked in to this strong, supportive community that will grow them right here and keep them here in our county.
I can only echo what Dr. Morris said, and from my experience, whenever I talk to adults in the business community or the educational community about what Dr. Morris and I are working on, and we tell them the experiences that the students are having and what we're bringing to the table, they just tell me they wish they could be a student all over again.
Thank you, Tiffany and Jim. And to now call up the early STEM learning group, Claudia and Carrie, please come up.
A little STEM learning here about how to use the computer. I also just want to mention that our active chairs, Dr. Carola Matera and Dr. Betsy Quintero, really do wish they could have been here. And it's been quite an engaged, enthusiastic group, and we will just speak on their behalf. So I was going to start my remarks about something that a very wise university president once said to me about the sense of wonder with his grandchildren. That very wise president happens to be here. But basically, when we talk about our vision, that's exactly what we're talking about. A lot of people have said to us, early STEM, what are you talking about STEM in preschool? And that's where we have to begin. In fact, our group talks about that preschool, we should be talking about age birth, at birth, or in the womb, prenatal. So we're looking at that too. But that's our opportunity to really build our foundation and to make sure that that foundation is there, that as the child goes through school, goes through life, that there's really something strong to build on it. And what is it about? It is about that sense of wonder. It is about that innate sense of curiosity that children have. It's about developing a sense of inquiry. We know in these early years, we have such an opportunity. We know that from brain science, and I'm sure all of you are familiar with brain research that tells us what's happening in the brain. But what we also know is that it doesn't happen unless we have the types of experiences that shape our brain and make that happen. And that's why it's so important that we begin to look at this in the early years. We've seen a lot of research on preschool, and I think many of you are familiar in terms of the return on investment we get from preschool. It's invest $1 a day, you get $7 back over the course of a lifetime. Pretty amazing, I wish I would get that. Pretty amazing return on investment. Interestingly enough, there's been some new research. The research on preschool has really focused on early literacy skills. Important, very important. There's been some additional research that really looks at early numeracy skills and finds that early numeracy skills may indeed be a better predictor of later academic success than just looking at early literacy skills. That's our vision.
Our vision is to take this opportunity to build upon it so that we have the foundation that children never lose that sense of wonder, never lose that sense of inquiry, and have the confidence that I can do this too. Carrie's going to talk about our goals for the group.
So I'm going to share some of the nuts and bolts of our process. We've had a group that has met twice now, about 35 people from various early childhood leadership positions in our county, from school districts, the early learning program directors, to our TK to third grade leaders, Child Development Incorporated, Child Development Resources, Scott Wings, Libraries First Five, County Office, Ventura College Local Planning Council, California Preschool Instructional Network. So this really great body of people have been meeting, and a lot of passion went into landing on the goals and the vision for this particular work group. In looking at where we're going next, with the support of our Bay Area facilitators, we have four workshops that are under development right now that will occur between January and June. And what's exciting about this is that we will be partnering with our Bay Area STEM friends to co-convene these workshops via video conferencing. So we'll be able to utilize both our local expertise as well as regional STEM expertise and have real-time conversations around STEM, focusing first on math. And we will be starting this effort with highlighting a program from Ventura County, a preschool program, and we'll be supported in developing what we're calling telling cases. So we'll be videoing practices within the classroom and sharing them within this series of four workshops. So very exciting, and if the stars align, we'll also be able to bring in some coaching to support our teachers and follow-up that have attended these workshops. So we're very proud of the work that's been accomplished already in just a short time frame, and also very excited about where this is going to take us. So.
Just a final word about the magic that's happened because of the network, and I really want to thank the leadership of BC STEM for really creating these convenings and this opportunity. What happens for preschool teachers is a lot of them feel like, math, science, I can't do that. I barely passed the course to get my degree, and now you want me to teach it? One of the magic that's happened because of a network is that people have realized that when you're looking and working with children, it's in all the learning that you do. It's not, okay, 11 o'clock, we're gonna have math class now. It's really how you integrate that developmental questioning, those developmental experiences, asking the what questions that really makes a difference. And the network has really allowed that to come together for people and to leave some of that fear behind and to begin to look at the possibilities. Really quickly, just a really short piece of anecdote that was shared to us by one of our programs, a preschool program that largely sees 2 and 3 year olds. They were doing a gardening program and they really felt it was about gardening, which it was, and it was about nutrition, which it was. But when they wrote about it, they talked about how teachers are proud to see parents and children stop at the garden each morning to observe changes, take measurements, and make predictions, such as how long until the green strawberry would ripen and be ready to eat. That's BC STEM in the early years. Tomorrow's scientists are doing their field research at recess by looking at that fallen leaf and analyzing the structure. Thank you.
One of the articles on my reading list is Eyeballs in a Refrigerator. That's about encouraging kids to get interested in science. Our next group is the Expanded Learning Group, represented by Sandy Birmingham and by Julia Chambers today.
A lot more people came. This is great.
Welcome to the Maritime Museum. That's what I usually stand at this podium and say, as I'm the director of this wonderful museum, and I'm just so glad to welcome you in that capacity as well. There are so many things going on here, but I know we all have some cake to eat outside or something, Phil, so I won't go on too long. But this institution, our docents are so proud to welcome you today. They will be giving you a taste of our education program. You can walk around and see all the different things that we offer to thousands of school children every day. And I'll tell you a little bit more about that in my comments, but Sandy is my moral support here, and she's gonna let me keep talking. But Phil, I'm assuming I'm just gonna hit that. Okay, good. So expanded learning, we have met twice, and Ginger Shea is our third co-chair, and she was not able to make it today. But we were able to welcome, again, 35 or perhaps 40 innovators in our community who came together, and we all sat at tables in first, and the ice was broken, and then all of a sudden the ideas started pouring out. And what, I mean, Phil and Marcella, we were all there, and we sat in the room thinking, what do we do? And then by the end of the afternoons, both of them, people had everyone's phone number, the business cards were exchanged, and the associations were already happening. Because with expanded learning, just you guys can read as well, but we were a very diverse group. We had educators, but also as a museum person, I was just so thrilled to be invited, because I became a museum person because I wanted people to engage in a real life way. We are able in this museum to offer them 5 centuries of art that sails. People have no idea, in this corner of Oxnard, there are Dutch masters downstairs. How often do you get to be up close with something that exquisite? And how many other people have resources just as exceptional to share? Well, we found out all about them, and our next steps will be to continue those alliances. A couple of examples, we had Cause from BeWet, and he does a lot of work taking students out to Santa Rosa Island, yeah, and he is with CSUCI. And so he immediately wanted to hear all about how we, in our capacity, have a program called Every Fifth Grader on the Water. It's funded by the Smith Foundation primarily, where we are able to bring Oxnard students, it's limited to Oxnard, fifth graders we're aiming for, so we don't repeat people who've had it 2 years now. They come to the museum, they hear all about maritime history, and then we put them, you can probably see the boat out there past the sea lions, out on the water for the first time, literally. These children, many of whom do not come to the water, and yet they live a mile away, inland oftentimes, have never felt the waves beneath their feet. And it's such an exciting day to get to come here, because this is a very exciting museum, and then go out there for the first time and learn and kiss a sea cucumber, apparently is the highlight of it. But to be able to meet with, Cause, and that's just one of the many, many examples. We had Mary Marinville from SEAG coming in, who does a lot of work with Limonera out in the fields, teaching children how it is to grow vegetables and where they come from and explaining that, who could easily meet with Gulling's Children's Museum and allow that collaboration to happen. Understanding the resources, seeing what's out there, it's taking everything we're all doing together and not reinventing the wheel. That's the other thing, is we all said we must put all of these things on a collective website or a collective resource that not only do we know what each other is doing, but also everybody in the community can have an idea of what we are doing. So, so our goals. As I said, all of these things, but to create a structure and to meet not only museum to museum or program to program, but I loved how many instructors were there, how many educators were there. And I have to give one more example too, because I see Bijan Phan back there in the audience and Jerry Clifford. Bijan is a wonderful artist, and with Gulling's Children's Museum, he has created a program called Origami Math Genius, otherwise known as OMG. Good job, Bijan. And So what happens is children come into the museum and they learn all about the basics of origami and physics and everything else and math, and they're learning it, but they're playing. So we hope very much that Bijan and Jerry Clifford, another CSECI professor, will be involved in the expansion of the Children's Museum as they look for a bigger space so that we can have a maker space and all of these things to support what the educators are doing. So, and again, prepare for the real world experiences. So we also are thrilled to be in this organization with all of the people that came together so we can expand with Pathways. It's just such a beautiful marriage. I just am thrilled about all of this. And then again, partnerships and that we never knew could have existed if we all hadn't been in the same room together next door. Okay, thank you.
And then finally, and I'm gonna let my co-chairs do this one, not me. I'd like to bring up Colleen Robertson and Brady Hanrahan to speak to the Professional Learning Action Group.
Okay, so we were the Professional Learning. You know, I want to say, if you can think back 20 years ago, remember how frightened educators were of technology? Computers? Well, I'm going to send it to the computer lab with the computer lady, but don't ask me to do anything. So imagine now how they're trembling when you say to a second grade teacher, we want you to introduce engineering. It's that fear all over again. Well, what part of what our goal is in the professional learning is to alleviate those fears, to give them resources. We actually started with three questions. Our first question, how does preparing and supporting STEM educators support STEM learning and teaching? A second question we ask, what is the role of school and teacher leaders in creating the conditions for STEM teaching and learning? And finally, how can we integrate and leverage the different resources that would contribute to professional STEM learning for educators and leaders? We met many times, used many pieces of poster paper, many post-its. We had stuff all over the room, and we actually came down to an 11-word vision. And that vision is that STEM professional learning strives to unite our community around STEM learning. So when we're talking about that community, we are including families, we're including businesses, we're including our teachers, that whole community, that whole system that helps to educate our children. We've come to a place now where we're so dependent on our technology. If you want to find something out, what do you do? What do? You Google it, right? Okay? Google has become a noun and a verb. So maybe one of our goals is to create I'm gonna say a warehouse, but not in a negative way, a place that has so many resources for our teachers and for our families that when they want to know something about science, about technology, about engineering or math, what are they going to do? They're going to VC STEM it. And I just want to say, a picture is worth a thousand words, and I don't know if you can see it from there, but I have a picture of some children who were involved in a STEM activity. And really, what is it all about? Creating that love, that joy, that energy that comes from learning. And I'll leave this picture up on I put it back where the water table is. Their faces are pure joy of learning. And that ultimately is our goal, isn't it?
How can I follow that? I'm still thinking about SMET.
That's probably SMET.
It is. Before I talk about, can we talk about levels already, or is that happen? Okay. I just want to echo the point about teacher training and the importance of technology. I was fortunate to have a very excellent high school teacher who was actually a PhD, who came from the academia, an R1 institution to teach high school. And I was fortunate enough to learn the skills from him as I moved forward. My interest in chemistry, I followed that career path all the way through graduate school and now Cal Lutheran. I'm no longer a teacher, but I am involved in faculty development. I think faculty development relates directly to teacher training. It's a great combination, and I'm lucky to to work with my faculty in the School of Education and help develop her teaching skills through our Center of Teaching and Learning. So I understand the importance of that. So I don't know if I'm going to read them word to word, but I guess define high quality STEM teaching and learning in the context of Ventura County. We have unique needs here in Ventura County. Develop criteria to recognize and honor our STEM teaching and learning models in various settings. Disseminate what works and what is worth doing in STEM teaching and learning. Those are some of our goals. An integrated approach, I think that's important. You mentioned the importance of technology and other aspects. I think resources are important here as well. Provide districts with models that demonstrate strategies for planning and delivering effective teaching methods and curriculum and pedagogy. Increase administrative capacity to lead in innovative times with an entrepreneurial mindset. I think part of our goal also is to help educate administrators in the school districts as well as the universities. So I think that's it. That's right. Great.
So all of this planning would not have been possible if we wouldn't have had a large number of stakeholders coming to each of these convenings. We had amazing representation across sector at our convenings. Energy was just through the roof. Connections were being made. Partnerships formed. Collaboration continued to happen. It was just truly amazing. I'm not supposed to pass it back to President Rush.
Great, thank you, Phil. You know, it's very gratifying for me because when I was the co-founder of P20 Council about 13 years ago, the purpose that we had in mind was that we would bring everybody together, that we would find all the resources that were discrete in the community, but bring them in a collaborative way so that we could have a focal point and utilize all those resources for a common purpose. And it's very gratifying to see what has come to pass through VC STEM. I know that my colleagues on the P20 Council will congratulate Phil and everybody involved with this because it really is the realization of a dream. So thank you to everybody. Thank you for your time and your talent. Thank you for your vision. It is my hope that in the future we will not only continue this, but we'll be able to expand it. Because when we utilize all of these resources for the common good, it really shows what can be accomplished when people of goodwill and talent really are committed to a singular purpose. So at this point, I want to thank everyone for attending this session of the beginning of VC STEM, the public opening of it, and Phil, you and I are doing the Phil and Dick show. I think I kick it back to you. Let me just do a little two-step and then you say.
You don't want me to sing. All right, thank you all for joining us today for this informational session about what we've been up to this last year with the very generous support of Amgen Foundation and the energy and enthusiasm of all of our partners. So I want to draw your attention to what happens next. So don't leave. So cake's coming. Cake is coming. It's not going to come quickly, but cake will be coming closer to about 5:15. So I'd like you to consider milling around the Maritime Museum here. Julia has some stations where people will be talking about particular aspects of the museum, giving you information. You can also go over and tour the Channel Islands Boating Center right next door. That was a partnership with the city of Oxnard and Cal State Channel Islands. Amazing educational facility and beautiful. They have a lot of interesting exhibits in the downstairs area. At 4 o'clock, we're going to be joined by additional people. Approximately 105 people have done RSVPs to come. I even managed to twist my wife's arm to come on down here because my son just wants to game. Not a scientist yet, but working on it. So I'd like to have all of your help and to try to guide these individuals to where they need to go. It's the caged area, because we need to be caged, but it's the fenced area with all the chairs. Please try to, if you find people wandering around, please try to direct them, because that's where they're supposed to be. Between 4 o'clock and 4:30, a lot of networking, and please join us in taking a look at some of those networking opportunities. We've got some examples of partnership that are being displayed there, including some examples of science carnival activities, safe ones. I didn't bring any flames, did I? I really did. Yeah, elephant toothpaste is on the roof of my truck, but it's not going to be out there. See, he winced at that one. So in closing, I'd just like to say, President Rush once said, if you want to travel fast, travel alone. If you want to travel far, travel together. We are embarking on a wonderful journey together. And as hosts for this event, we ask you to help us encourage attendees to gather and be seated by 4:23. That's an exact number, 4:23, so that we can begin the launch ceremony and celebrate promptly at 4:30 p.m. We're going to have an innovative ribbon cutting today. It doesn't involve any flames either. Thank you for coming today. There are copies of an annual report on your chair. Please take a look at that. If you have questions, please feel free to contact us. Another thing brought to us by Fiverr. Official today as a STEM regional network. So this whole journey began about 3 years ago, but before we get into that, I'd like to call President Rush up here to welcome us. President Rush.
Thank you, Phil. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this very, very special occasion. We're here today to celebrate the launch of the VC STEM Regional Collaborative, an initiative of the Ventura County P20 Council, currently facilitated by Cal State Channel Islands through the generous funding of the Amgen Foundation. VC STEM is a collaboration of a wide range of regional stakeholders building upon the good work that is already being done by numerous organizations across Ventura County and bring together these efforts into one collective vision. VC STEM will also serve as a leadership hub for regional stakeholders working together to promote excellence in P20 STEM and to prepare our students for the needs and demands of the 21st century. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, 7.2% of Ventura County region employment is in STEM. Like the rest of the nation, that percentage is anticipated to increase. STEM-related jobs in the United States are projected to grow more than by 9 million by 2022. So this effort of VC STEM is significantly important. I'm also proud to share with you that VC STEM was recently named a STEM ecosystem by the STEM Funders Network, one of only 27 regions nationwide devoted to creating STEM learning opportunities for students from preschool through college. The Ventura County P20 Council supports this effort, and the council is about 12 years old, I estimate, and my co-founder, Dr. Chuck Weiss, is here with us today. He and I had lunch one day and we said, you know what's needed? We need one of these collaborative efforts. And I think we both are gratified by the way that Ventura County P20 Council has expanded and supported all the efforts of the school district throughout the region. That's its sole purpose, not to interfere, not to intrude, but to be supportive and to provide a network and a matrix from P all the way through college and indeed through life to show what the regional resources are and how to access them. I would like at this time to introduce the P20 Council members who are able to join us today, and I would ask them to stand and be recognized. Please hold your applause until all have been identified. First of all, Bernie Luskin, the Chancellor of the Ventura County Community College District, Chris Yonke, hey, follow directions. If you two can't obey orders, we're going to have to remove you. I mean, Selena, you're a bad influence. Secondly, Chris Yonke, the commanding officer of Naval Base Ventura County, Eric Harrison, the president and CEO of the United Way of Ventura County, Claudia Harrison, the executive director of First Five of Ventura County, Cheryl Moore, the Workforce Development Board executive director, Richard Duarte, the project coordinator for P20 Council, and also Chuck Weiss, the co-founder of the P20 Council. Please join with me in acknowledging their efforts. We are also pleased and gratified to have elected officials, representatives with us today. Again, I would ask them to stand. They brought certificates which they'll present at the end of our program, but I would ask them to stand and be recognized for what they do and for the work of the elected officials they represent. First, Colleen Robertson, the superintendent of Soma School District, and representing Congresswoman Julia Brownlee, Jason Barnes, representing Assemblywoman Jackie Irwin, Jeanette Sanchez, representing Assemblyman Doss Williams, Maggie El-Susu, representing Assemblyman Scott Wilk, Pam Campo. Thank you for being with us, and thank you for your election officials. Leadership is the key ingredient of any movement. As I tell the faculty, you gotta have a great president who's good looking, intelligent, suave, continental, debonair, but that's about me. Leadership is the key ingredient of any movement, and I'd like to acknowledge VC STEM Steering Committee, led by Dr. Phil Hampton, who has navigated the way forward from a good idea to a meaningful action. Again, please stand and let us acknowledge you. Julia Chambers, Richard Duarte, Dr. Grady Hanrahan, Claudia Harrison, Nathan Inouye, Monica James, Marcella Klein-Williams, Dr. Tiffany Morse, Jim Rose, and Maria Steck. Thank you for all the efforts that you have expended. We would not have been able to move from a good idea to implementation without support. And I would like at this time to recognize the Amgen Foundation and thank them for their generous contribution of $75,000 investing in the planning of VC STEM and the investment in our children and in our county's future. We're delighted to have Amgen as our partner. And I'd like to have Dr. Cindy Osfari, Vice President of the Department of Comparative Biology and Safety Sciences, and the chair of the Amgen Foundation Grant Review Committee to come forward for a few words. Dr. Osfari.
Thank you very much. It's quite an exciting day, and I'm happy to be able to be here to celebrate the launch of the ecosystem and the next venture for VC STEM. Ventura County is home to Amgen's global headquarters, and as a science-based company, we're heavily invested in inspiring the innovators of tomorrow, particularly those in our own backyard. Looking beyond our company and even the biotechnology industry, we need an educated workforce to ensure that scientific innovations continue. Innovation doesn't happen in a vacuum. It requires creativity, content expertise, and willingness to take risks and think outside the box. After a year of strategic outreach and deliberate planning, VC STEM is well positioned to dig into the important work of strengthening STEM education for Ventura County students. As a founding funder of VC STEM, the Amgen Foundation is proud of the work of this collaborative and what it's accomplished to date, and we're excited to be part of its future. The Amgen Foundation is committed to raising the value of science literacy through strengthening the science teacher quality and professional development, along with offering pivotal hands-on scientific experiences that significantly impact students' excitement about science and scientific careers. We recognize that addressing the global STEM gap requires partnership between industry, academic institutions, government, and nonprofit organizations. This enables creating a greater capacity for innovation. That is precisely what VC STEM is positioned to do for our community. We are enthusiastic about the multi-sector partnership that is being developed by VC STEM and look forward to actively participating in the evolution of the VC STEM learning ecosystem. On behalf of the Amgen Foundation, it is my pleasure to present VC STEM with a $100,000 grant to continue to support this innovative model and its commitment to our future innovators. Thank you to all of you who've been involved for your commitment to STEM education. Thank you.
Could I ask the steering committee to come up and be part of the check presentation, please? And as well as the co-chairs. I was going to be able to take this check and get out of here. Cindy, you can come anytime. You just, we love to have you. Please accept my apology. I overlooked two representatives of our elected officials. First is Pat Saraceno representing Congressman Steve Knight. And representing Senator Hannah Beth Jackson is Stanley Sonkov. Where are you, Stanley? Well, at this time, part of the handoff, I'm delighted to welcome back to the stage Dr. Phil Hampton to give you an overview of the doings of VC STEM and its exciting future. Phil?
Thanks, Dick. So the journey of the Ventura County STEM Regional Network takes us back to probably about 2011 or maybe even a little bit earlier. I remember having a coffee with John Tarkany and talking about how we really needed something in our region to help stimulate STEM jobs. And we called it back then
STEM County, didn't really know what it was going to look like. And then come around 2011 or so, Marcella Klein-Williams with California STEM Learning Network at that time came to us and said, how about a STEM regional network in Ventura County? How about that? And she was meeting with all types of stakeholders in our region and kind of energized our region to think about becoming a STEM regional network. And at that point, we started attending meetings of the California STEM Learning Network and became in kind of a probationary member of that CSLNet entity. And there are, I don't know if you know this, I think there are 13 STEM regional networks all across the state of California, ranging from Northern California all the way down to San Diego. And amazing organizations like OC STEM, the Orange County STEM Network, and the Los Angeles STEM Network. So that initial journey kind of sat there for a while. We had a core group of three of us, Cynthia Herrera, Marcella Klein-Williams, Gary Kinsey, and myself, who would attend these meetings, but we weren't really making the groundwork. And then we had the unique opportunity last fall to apply to Amgen Foundation for a grant. And when I presented a set of ideas to, at that time, it was Scott Heimlich and Jessica Halloran, they seized upon the idea of building a STEM regional network in our region. It could have almost as much been Phil's Play Bus, where we bring science out to the community. But no, they chose the STEM regional network. I'm still going to pitch the other idea, though, the STEM Bus. So we have this unique opportunity, thanks to the generosity of Amgen Foundation last fall, to have this planning year to take a look at how can we build a STEM regional network in our county. And quite importantly, we launched this initiative under the P20 Council, this interdisciplinary, cross-sector represented organization that's focused on improving educational outcomes for kids from PK all the way up through graduate school. And so as an initiative under the P20 Council, VC STEM launched as a planning process in December of 2014. And over this planning year, we formed a core group of stakeholders, steering committee members, who have helped lead this group. And they all stood earlier. We'll get them back up here on the stage for the ribbon cutting later on. But they're a powerful group that have been dedicated to launching VC STEM in our region. Shortly after we formed our steering committee group, we coalesced around a mission statement. And our mission statement now, you know, the cement is setting. It's almost completely set. By 5:15, it will be solid. Our mission is, the Ventura County STEM Network serves as a leadership hub for regional stakeholders who are working together to improve educational outcomes in STEM throughout Ventura County. And we also solidified a vision statement, which is that the vision of VC STEM is that all P20 students in Ventura County benefit from high quality STEM learning opportunities, graduate with the STEM knowledge, skills, and applied learning capabilities necessary for success in STEM and non-STEM college education and careers, and possess the STEM knowledge, skills, and awareness to positively impact our region, the nation, and the world. So that mission and vision then led to the formation of action groups. We looked for areas where we wanted to start our initial work. We formed a total of 3 action groups, and then we pulled into our work a 4th area that was already very well established through the Career Pathways programs, and now coordinating our work with their work. Our first action group was at the PK through grade 3 level. It's entitled Early STEM Learning, focusing on math and science competency at very early ages. Get them hooked on science early. Great book, Eyeballs in the Freezer, or is it the refrigerator? Still want to read it. At the K through 8 level, we launched 2 action groups, one of them entitled The Expanded Learning Opportunities in STEM, that was going to look at after-school programming, how to integrate STEM into after-school business, getting the informal education at the museums, and getting parents involved in education. A 3rd action area was the professional learning opportunities in STEM for educators, which takes a look at how to enhance our teachers, educators, and leaders' knowledge of and ability to lead STEM excellent organizations in our community. And then the final action area, the College and Career Pathways program, led by Tiffany Morris and Jim Rhodes from Oxnard Union High School District. That area, well-funded through a total of now 3 grants from the California Department of Education, is working to build career pathways for our youth all the way from middle school up through high school. So it's at this point in time I'd like to turn the microphone over to our action groups for them to give a very short synopsis of what their action groups will be taking a look at. And so what I'd like to do is I'd like to start with the youngest of the young kids with our early STEM learning action group. And Claudia, are you going to lead this one? And Carrie Murphy, okay. We have 4 action group leaders for this area. Our 4 action group areas in early STEM include Claudia Harrison, who's the executive director of First 5 Ventura County, Dr. Carola Matera, assistant professor in early childhood at Cal State Channel Islands, Carrie Murphy, director of early childhood programs at Ventura County Office of Education, and Dr. Elizabeth Quintero, professor of education at Cal State Channel Islands.
I'm not quite as tall as Phil. Thank you. Good afternoon. You know, a lot of people have said to me, early learning STEM, really? What's that about? You're going to talk about STEM in preschool? Why are we doing that? It's because we know that the early learning is really the foundation of what we can build for STEM. We know that children have an innate curiosity, a natural sense of wonder. They're developing their sense of inquiry. We get to build the foundation that really we then get to build the later experiences on. We know from brain development that those early years are an incredible opportunity because the brain is forming. But we also know is that the brain depends on the experiences that is happening for it to really form well. And that's what we get to do by putting early learning STEM in place. Many of you are probably familiar with research on preschool and the return on investment that they've looked at. The dollar in gets you $7 back, and I wish I could get that return. It's really quite wonderful. What we know is that a lot of that research focuses on early literacy, which is incredibly important. But we have new research now that also tells us that early numeracy is as good or even better predictor of later achievement and later skills as is early literacy. I'm going to ask Carrie to say a few words about the goals and the work of the action group, and then I'll come back for a few words.
Okay. Thanks, Claudia. So being very brief, our action group has met twice. We have a group of 35 very enthusiastic, very engaged members representing the early childhood leadership within our county, as well as representation from TK to 3. Very important for us to have a birth through third grade continuum developing the goals and the mission of this group. We, in terms of next steps, where we're going, we're very excited that we have assembled 4 professional development offerings that will occur between January and June, and we are partnering with some Bay Area counties that are STEM leaders, and we will be co-hosting these professional development offerings via video conference and so forth. And if the stars align, we will also embed some coaching to do some follow-up support with our teachers.
So just in case you're still wondering, but I still don't get it. What does STEM look like? Really, do they stop the preschool class and say it's 9:30, it's math, and it's 11:15, and it's science? The wonderful thing about early learning STEM is that it gets integrated into everything that's happening with children. And it's about asking the right questions. It's about putting the right experiences in place. I'm going to just briefly share a little anecdote we have from one of our programs that they were doing an activity, and for them the activity was about gardening. The activity was about nutrition, and it really was about gardening and nutrition, but this is the part that I loved. Teachers were proud to see parents and children stop at the garden each morning to observe changes, take measurements, and make predictions, such as how long until a green strawberry would ripen and be ready to eat. That's what STEM looks like in early learning. Tomorrow's scientist is doing his field research at recess, analyzing the structure of a fallen leaf
to see what it's all about. Thank you.
I'd like to now bring up our two of our STEM Expanded Learning co-chairs to speak briefly on their action. We have three co-chairs of the Expanded Learning group. Sandy Birmingham, who is Associate Director of STEM Educational Outreach at Cal State Channel Islands. Julia Chambers, Board President of Gullwings Children Museum and Executive Director of this amazing facility right next door, the Channel Islands Maritime Museum. And finally, Ginger Shea, Manager of Special Programs in the Oxnard School District, who couldn't be with us today.
Thank you, Phil. What a pleasure to see you all today. I'm usually inviting people to enjoy the museum next door, which I am going to do. Please come and visit the Maritime Museum right next door anytime. We're open almost every day. But Sandy and I were so happy to host two of the Expanding Learning sessions right upstairs. And our goals were to bring people who think regularly outside of the box. Bring them in with educators, museum people, librarians, and I can tell you every different type of person. So we may have had the most fun session, I'm pretty sure, because people came in, they sat at the tables and said, who is here? And then we were all exchanging business cards, forming alliances, making things happen instantaneously, and I'm so proud to be part of that group. As a museum person, Sandy can jump in anytime, but as an educator, but it was just a wonderful synergy created on so many levels that collaborated and started something right away. But as a museum person, I heard a story lately where somebody said, well, why should I go to a museum? They're kind of crusty and boring, and all I'm going to do is just walk through and wait, find the cafe. And then he got a tour, and it was a tour unlike any he had ever had. And he was able to come out afterward and said, you know what's great about museums is that I can stand 3 feet away from an object that is 4,000 years old from the Babylonian period. When do I ever get to do that? And the comparison here is everybody who came upstairs to that session, whether you have a painting from 500 years ago, or you have the most amazing after-school program where you're creating something new, the children and the grown-ups get to experience that. And then we collaborate with the educators who bring it to their classrooms, who bring their classrooms to these wonderful places, after school, during field trips, and every other moment of the day. There's a wonderful, one of the wonderful alliances that happened already was with Ginger Shea, who's not here today, but the after-school program for Oxnard School District comes once a week to the Maritime Museum, and they bring their iPads, and they study beforehand, and they understand about biology and history and everything else that's coming together because we got a lovely grant that could bring them by bus to the museum. And that's just one tiny collaboration that has happened and are continuing to happen all the time. So the success of our sessions, we're proud, right, Sandy? Yes. It was a wonderful experience and an example of how important VC STEM is for us to bring everybody together to realize we don't have to reinvent the wheel. The wheel is spinning in Ventura County, and we are all part of it, and I'm so happy. Thank you so much.
I'd like to bring up Grady and Colleen, if you could speak on our third area, which is the professional learning. Our co-chairs for this convening, or this action group, are Dr. Colleen Robertson, who's superintendent of the Somas Union School District, Dr. Grady Hanrahan, professor and associate provost for experiential learning, and then myself. But I'm going to let them do the talking.
All right. It's not a lesson in solar, but I'm really sorry that you have to look in that direction. How many educators in the audience? Raise your hand. Oh, lots. Okay, go put your hands down. So, do you remember about, 15, 20 years ago when they were bringing technology into the schools and a lot of teachers like, no, thank you, just send the kids off to the lab and let the lab the lab technician, teach them what they needed to know. And it was kind of a rough road to get them involved. And why? Because it was another thing on their plate and they really weren't trained. What we're focusing in on is to try to give them tools, resources, so that teachers don't see this as another intrusion, but to really see how powerful, and isn't this one of the most exciting times in education? Truly one of the most exciting times. So our goal, like I said, is to, we started with three questions. Our first question as we were deciding what we needed to do, number one, how does preparing and supporting STEAM educators support STEM? We got arts in my district. STEAM teaching and learning. Our second question was, what is the role of a school and teacher leader in creating the conditions for STEM teaching and learning? And finally, how do we integrate and leverage the different resources and how will those contribute to professional STEM learning for educators and our learners? And so it's really been very, very exciting. We worked with a lot of people. We're basically trying to put together these resources so that teachers will be able to, I said earlier, right now, if you want to find out some information, what do? You get out your phone and you, what do? Yeah, Google it. So our goal is that education leader, as a teacher, you can get out your device and you can VC STEM it. All right, that's our goal.
Just very briefly, the word synergy was used earlier, and I would really think that encapsulates what we're doing in this learning group and all learning groups. It's providing a work-life balance for our teachers in the community, providing administrators with training as well as teacher training. So thank you for being here today.
And our fourth and final action group is College and Career Pathways, STEM College and Career Pathways. And the co-chairs are Dr. Tiffany Morse, Director of Career Education, Ventura County Office of Education, and Jim Rose, Career Pathways and Community Partnerships, Oxnard Union High School District.
Just for the record, I think there should be a rule against pictures when it's windy outside. The word pathways gets thrown around a lot, and admittedly, it means a lot of different things in a lot of different places. So pathways in Oxnard Union High School districts look very different than pathways in Ventura Unified or Simi Valley or anywhere else in the county. But I want to tell you a story about what pathways feel like. So a few months ago, we were partnering with our friends at Naval Base Ventura County, and we had a STEM tour happening. And we have some administrators that don't consider themselves to be STEM people. Like, I'm an English person or I'm a history person. And so we had an administrator and I sent him as a chaperone because we really needed a chaperone, but really because I need him to understand what STEM is all about. So he went on this tour and afterwards I said, how'd it go? And he said, Tiffany, if you'd asked me what engineers did this morning, I would have said, I don't know, something with railroads or something. But it's really amazing. They're doing really, really cool things out there in Naval Base Ventura County behind the gates that we don't even know about. So his daughter is in eighth grade here locally. She goes to a magnet school. And he went home and he said, you should be an engineer. And she said, Dad, I don't want to do that. That's boring. And he said, no, it's really cool. And she said, I don't want to do that. So being a good parent of an eighth grader, he signed her up anyways for the STEM camp over the summer. And she came back from the STEM camp and said, that is so cool. I think I want to be an engineer. So now imagine she goes to a high school and she has an engineering pathway as an option and she can take classes in intro to engineering and she can be on the robotics team and she can go on field trips and she can have mentors and guest speakers and all of these opportunities to engage with the local engineering community. And now, as of fall 2016, I heard earlier, she can go to Channel Islands University and major in engineering. And she can stay right here in our community and be employed right here in Ventura County as an engineer that we grew locally through our system and our collaborative network sitting here today.
Well, at this point, the cement has completely set. Our vision and mission are now established. We are VC STEM. And to celebrate VC STEM, yeah, let's give ourselves a hand. So as we were thinking about a ribbon cutting, you know, what's a ribbon cutting when it comes to creating an entity like BC STEM? We thought, let's do something STEM-y. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take a bridge built by the high school winners at Wainimi High School Engineering Academy from this past summer. The instructor for that is Professor Greg Wood from Cal State Channel Islands. So they built a bridge, and we're going to break that bridge. And at the culmination of breaking the bridge, we are officially launched. So we need to do a little bit of logistics up here. We need a basket. We need some water. And then we're going to bring up the co-chairs of all of our action groups. It's going to be tight fit up here, but we're all going to squeeze in here. What's that? The other way? I don't know what you're pointing at. I'm getting signals from Marcella here that I don't know.
If we could first invite
Yes, okay, thank you. Let's clear the stage of space. And in fact, I'd like to have Jessica Halloran as well join us. She's our rep from Amgen Foundation and has interfaced with us on all of our grant proposals. Engineering process. I was instructed to give some numbers of math here, that the bridge only weighs 300 grams, that each water bottle weighs about the same amount of mass, and so we're trying to see how many water bottles does a bridge hold. And so what we're going to be doing here is, first of all, start by having President Rush, Cindy, and Jessica put in a water bottle to see if it breaks with three water bottles. So come on up. No pressure. And actually, I'd like to have in the backdrop here our steering committee and co-chairs standing up here. If we can fit the P20 Council up here, let's put them up here as well, because I'd just like to have everybody here for the bridge breaking. Come on, Tiffany. Okay, special instructions. Put the water bottles in gently. You know that a falling water bottle will have more force than a gently placed one.
Sorry, okay.
Sure. That works for me. Or they can come up on the stage, put the water bottle in and stand. Let's do that. Come on up. Yes, please.
And what's your name?
Richard.
Richard Smith, who designed and built the bridge.
Okay. I know.
All right, what are your names? Jose Martinez.
Ricardo Gonzalez.
They were the co-builders. The winning team. We got one more high school student coming up here too.
From what school?
These are all from Wainimi High School. What's your name?
Augustine.
Augustine. And Jessica Halloran just put in a water bottle. President Rush, gently.
Don't drop it.
Don't drop it. Careful. Careful.
Gently, Bernie. Yeah, what number is that now? Is anybody counting?
Five.
That's five. We can count. Five, six now? That must be number nine, I think. We got nine people on stage here. Okay, who's next? Yeah, we'll let the experts adjust it. Put in a water bottle, come up on the stage for a photo op. All of the co-chairs, P20. We're gonna see how much weight the stage takes. Next. So for the record, the summer had an 18 bottle bridge. We got cheated. Thank you. So I get to turn it back to President Rush now for our closing. Thank you, Phil. Thank you all of the collaborators who have helped to make this so successful. As we look forward, our hope for the future is so exciting and so positive that I know that our children and our region will benefit from all of this. I'd like to invite you all to stay, enjoy the student demonstrations. If you haven't played a banana yet, you can. If you play the piano, you play a banana. And we also have cake. We have to cut the cake and celebrate. And now, back to Phil for a few more housekeeping. This is great, Phil. You and I. Yeah, we should do a duet in karaoke next. So, to wrap up, I'd like to just invite you to continue to stay and interact with our tables of examples of partnerships and networking in Ventura County. We've got some frozen marshmallows and saltine crackers if you don't like cake. And I'd like to just say that not everybody gets to stay, that the P20 Council and the Arches executive team and President Rush have to get back to work. They get to go upstairs after this. And their meeting will begin at 5:30. And so one of the things about VC STEM is that it will be pulling people together, building bridges, not breaking bridges, building bridges between things that exist, areas of excellence in our community, and to try to make those bridges stronger so that all of our children benefit from high quality STEM opportunities. So in conclusion, a famous man once said, standing next to me, if you want to travel fast, travel alone. If you want to travel far, travel together. We're embarking on a wonderful journey today, and we want to do it with you, and we want you as our partners. Thank you.